when I first came to Newsday in 1998, everybody said, you gotta write about grandma pizza. And I said, what's grandma pizza?
I like my grandma, like, not too thin, not too thick.
I personally like it a little bit on the burnt side.
Grandma pie is a nice pizza.
Variations abound. Ciro Cesarano likes super thin dough. He trims the edges so that it has no discernible crust. Umberto Corteo covers his dough with plastic wrap to stretch it out, which, he says, keeps it moist and keeps his hands clean. Angelo Giangrande's pie is thinner than Umberto's, but thicker than Ciro's. The basic outline is as follows. A thin layer of dough is stretched into a square Sicilian pan. It is topped sparingly with shredded mozzarella cheese and then uncooked seasoned tomatoes and maybe some pepper, garlic, or basil. Then it's baked until the top bubbles and the bottom is crispy.
That's what I'm looking for.
In 2003, I actually wrote that article about grandma pizza, and I really dug into who invented it. But it was complicated.
The origin of the grandma pizza was...
We invented grandma pie.
You know, sometimes you make things to just do something because probably you have nothing else better to do and it become a big thing.
But the grandma was a star here.
According to my research, grandma pizza was first made at Umberto's in New Hyde Park. But it wasn't sold there. Now, owner Umberto Corteo often takes credit for inventing the grandma pizza.
So one day I says, what am I going to cook for me? So I got a frying pan, stretch a little dough, I made special sauce, and I made the grandma's pizza. This is my special sauce, and I like to do this. All over.
I don't know exactly the year, but I was working in Umberto.
My brother was working for Umberto's. Umberto was making some rum pizza.
At first, I don't know what the hell to call the pizza anymore.
Like I say, Umberto, he had a different type of pizza, and he would call the pizza himself Pizza La Umberto.
I started to make the grandma's pizza for me and the helper. Or maybe a special friend, but I never put it on the market.
Umberto has a point. However, Grandma Pizza was first sold at King Umberto's in Elmont. Now, King Umberto's started out as a satellite of Umberto's, but pretty soon it was sold to two Umberto's employees, Sal and Rosario Fuschetto. And they, in turn, hired two more of Umberto's pizza makers, pizzaioli, Angelo Giangrande and Ciro Cesarano. Rosario's brother, Sal Fuschetto, is no longer with the business.
Sal was the one who first made the pie?
Yes. Sal and Giangrande.
I put a piece of dough on the tray, and I'm trying to stretch it, and one day I just decided to start to stretch to the pan. Try to make a little thinner because at the time that pizza would come up a little thick. And I started to use my own recipe and the sauce also. You want to see more like a little more sauce than the cheese. When I left Umberto, I started working with King Umberto's. The grandma pizza went on the menu after some kind of event that I went with Sal. Fuschetti, me and Emma went to this event and we bring some of this grandma pizza, which before nobody ever really knew what they were.
It was these guys who first put grandma pizza on the menu and, big innovation, they displayed it in the glass jewel case, not just on top of the counter where pizza by the slice used to be displayed.
We started making grandma by the slice. Nobody ever made the pizza by the slice and it was flying like crazy from that time. Everybody know about the grandma and you come in and do the article.
They got to cook at least for 7 minutes and then we put on the floor.
At the time, we didn't have a really name for that particular pie because nobody knew it would have become so popular.
It was King Umberto customer Tippi Nocello who came up with the name Grandma Pizza. Just as the Fuschetto brothers and Ciro Cesarano and Angelo Giangrande had moved from Umberto's to King Umberto's, in 2000, John Grande moved to his own pizzeria, Da Angelo in Albertson. And that's the way it went with pizza makers. They would work at a place that made grandma pizza, and then they would move to a place that didn't, and they would start making grandma pizza there. So in this way, grandma pizza moved south to the Five Towns, and north to the Gold Coast, and east to Suffolk, and then to Queens, and even across the river into Manhattan.
Everybody they make up their own grandma pizza.
Everybody put a sign on the window. Everybody put a sign. We do make a grandma, everybody. Umberto, every pizza man was, every pizzeria was a Long Island.
If it's not crispy, it's not my pizza.
I think that in their hearts, all of these guys really believe that they invented grandma pizza. So let's just agree that it was born on Long Island, and it's probably Long Island's greatest contribution to world gastronomy. Of all the stories I've done for Newsday, I think the one about grandma pizza has been the most enduring. It was reprinted in Ed Levine's book, Pizza, A Slice of Heaven. And every article or video I've seen since then has relied on my research. You know, the other day I looked up grandma pizza on Wikipedia and I was the earliest source cited. You know, it's good to be an authority on something, and I may be the world's foremost authority on grandma pizza.